In Egypt, the population has tripled over the last 50 years and now stands at 80 million. So the pressure on the land and the environment continues to increase dramatically. In the Nile Delta in particular, growing pollution and lack of adequate wastewater management are threatening the health of the population.
الصرف عندنا مش سالك ومواصير صغيره وعايزين نغيروا الشبكه الرئيسيه بتاعت الصرف ما فيش بالنسبه للميه يعني ما صاحب الميه ما بمشيش برد علينا ثاني ما فيش مكرف يرمي يطلع يسحب من البلد يرمي بره ما فيش فالميه ما بتسد بتعمل سد بترد علينا ثاني
مشاكلنا ان الصرف اللي بنصرفوه بيجي على ميه الشرب وده بيجي يخش في ده وبيشربوه ويلف يروح الترعه والترعه يروى منها والارض تاني بعد ده كلته ناكله اللي بيطلع من الارض وده كلته مش بيسبب مشاكل.
Egypt has been building centralized wastewater treatment plants for over 30 years. However, many people living outside the large cities cannot be served by these big systems. The Swiss State Secretariat for Economic Affairs, or SECO, is supporting an innovative project to propose new alternatives.
Urbanization in Egypt is happening so fast and is so heterogeneous that conventional centralized wastewater treatment system cannot be a solution for all. In order to encourage new approaches, the Swiss Corporation supported ESRIS, applied research project from the Eawag, in collaboration with the Egyptian water holding company for water and wastewater.
The chairman of the holding company for water and wastewater welcomes the Swiss cooperation.
Sanitation in Egypt here for small villages is a big challenge, mainly because, you know, this will require a lot of investigations to be done for all these villages. And also we have limited land in most of the Delta area particularly, which means that, you know, we don't have enough land to do treatment. We have different technologies all over Egypt. We are now evaluating these technologies, and then we will identify what kind of technology that can be used according to the conditions of the village.
The main objectives of the project were to identify challenges of small-scale sanitation in Egypt, and then to propose ways forward. The project team studied the needs of the population and looked at a variety of sanitation practices and solutions initiated by the villagers themselves.
احنا اتعاوننا واجتمعنا كلنا اهل البلد مع بعضيه وقلنا عاوزين نعملوا صرف علشان خاطر البيوت ديت ما تنهلكش ماشي طبعا جمعنا ولمينا مبلغ كبير وجبنا واحد مقاول ومشيناه في البلد وطبعا لمينا فلوس وعرفنا المصاريف قد ايه واتكلمنا مع المقاول على اساس انه يعمل لنا الصرف وفعلا نفذنا.
In a second step, the project analyzed the wastewater quality, investigated the operational management, and proposed recommendations for implementing sanitation systems.
We found out that villages are very heterogeneous. When planning in a village, we need a case-by-case approach. For this reason, we developed a tool for designers and consultants to estimate quickly the raw wastewater to be treated, the quantities and the characteristics, on a site-specific basis and without the need to take samples. This is important for the cost-effectiveness of the planning and the infrastructure.
While technical solutions exist and are affordable, the main challenge to widely applying these small-scale sanitation systems will be establishing a legal, regulatory, institutional framework. Professor Fatma El-Gohari believes that an incremental implementation of the treatment systems is the way forward.
We start with advanced primary treatment and then later, when it is possible, when we have more financial support and more qualified personnel, we can add to the existing systems secondary treatment or even advanced treatment, depending on the environmental, socio-economic environmental conditions.
Allowing a simple form of wastewater treatment in Egypt would already contribute to reducing the current level of pollution by more than 60%. Secondly, small-scale sanitation systems should be managed centrally. And finally, a national sanitation strategy should be established, which, among other things, will encourage private sector participation. For the Minister of Housing, efficient and well-run sanitation services are crucial for the development of Egypt.
Sewage collection and treatment in Egypt rural areas is a priority for the government. We need to engage the private sector, the civil society, and the different stakeholders in this very important project. Our role is to really create the condition within which we will enable a quick increase of the sanitation coverage in the whole country, and specifically in the village and rural area. This requires definitely the participation of all concerned ministries and under the umbrella of a national plan. And basically, let's think out of the box for this very important project.
Basic water and sanitation infrastructure support economic development and reduce poverty. It is only with a clear political will and a readiness to collaborate that new solutions for sanitation will be possible in Egypt.